Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is the Monday of Holy Week. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Contend, O Lord, with my contenders. Fight those who fight me. Take up your buckler and shield. Arise in my defense, Lord, my mighty help.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that though in our weakness we fail, we may be revived through the passion of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nations, not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench. Until he establishes justice on the earth, the coastlands will wait for his teaching. Thus says God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth with its crops, who gives breath to its people and spirit to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from the confinement and from the dungeon those who live in darkness, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
When evildoers come at me to devour my flesh, my foes and my enemies themselves stumble and fall. Response.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Though an army encamp against me, my heart will not fear. Though war be waged upon me, even then will I trust. Response.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord. Response.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Hail to you, our King. You alone are the compassionate with our faults. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
6 days before Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, where Lazarus, whom Jesus had raised from the dead, lived. They gave a dinner for him there, and Martha served, while Lazarus was one of those reclining at table with him. Mary took a litter of costly perfume oil made from genuine aromatic nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and dried them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the oil. Then Judas the Iscariot, one of his disciples and the one who would betray him, said, "Why was this oil not sold for 300 days' wages and given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared for the poor, but because he was a thief and held a money bag and used to steal the contributions. So Jesus said, "Leave her alone. Let her keep this for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with me, but you do not always have me." The large crowd of the Jews found out that he was there and came, not only because of him, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. and the chief priests plotted to kill Lazarus too, because many of the Jews were turning away and believing in Jesus because of him. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So this Monday we enter now the, you might say, the climax of the drama as we begin Holy Week. Now we have here beautifully, I think, a very symbolic opening gospel for the week. You have the anointing of Jesus, really, you know, that in a sense Mary now anoints Jesus, you know, the anointing at Bethany. And remember, the anointing is always a very important ritual, no? It is the ritual wherein, ibig sabihin ng anointing ay tinatalaga tayo, eh. Yun yung kahalagahan ng anointing. That pag merong inanoint, ibig sabihin nun, isinasa isang tabiyan para maging ano, katulong sa trabaho ng Diyos. Diba? Mga bata, pag binibinyagan, diba, ina-anoint. Ang mga pare, pag inoordinahan, ina-anoint. No? And that's why yung anointing dito ng Panginoon sa umpisa ng Holy Week is very, very symbolic now, no? Of his being prepared for his mission. So that's the first point that I invite you to reflect on, no? And then the other point that I invite you to reflect on, especially as a preparation for our Holy Week prayer and reflection, is to take a look at the three persons in the gospel, no? You have Martha, you have Mary, and you have Judas, no? If you notice, Martha, as usual, true to form, diba, is serving the dinner. And I guess that is one part of our Christian vocation, the whole act of serving, of always attending to the needs of other people. And I guess especially during this Holy Week, no, wherein there is so much suffering around us. I mean, every day, the last weeks, we hear about people getting sick, you know, people needing to be moved from their families to stay in a quarantine area, and the daily wage earners, diba, dinadala ng pagkain. And maybe we can take some inspiration from Martha, no, during this Holy Week to ask ourselves, how can I be a Martha? Paano ba ako pwedeng maging Martha ngayong mga darating na araw, even up to Easter time, no, wherein we want to share also the blessings of the Lord. So that's the first relationship in the gospel, the Martha, the action, the service person, no? And the other one is Mary. Of course, Mary has always been equated to the prayer and reflection side. And it is Mary who does the one of the job of the spiritual service, no? She's the one who anoints Jesus, no? And as I said nga, di ba, to anoint is to make holy. Parang itabian para sa Diyos, di ba? And maybe itong darating na mga araw ay pwede rin natin ipagdasal ang mga tao, pagdasal ang ating mga kaibigan na alam natin nangangailangan ng biyaya ng Diyos. But to be Mary, no? To be Mary in terms of praying, in terms of anointing others, no? Even though we are separated, we can anoint others with our prayers. And perhaps, 'di ba, during this week of prayer and more and deeper reflection, anoint people that you know who are in need of God's blessings. No? You can anoint from a distance, di ba? You remember, nung bininyagan, halimbawa, yung mga anak ninyo, yung mga may anak, di ba? Sabi nung pare, basbasan nyo ang inyong mga anak araw-araw because you have the power to do so. And maybe now is the time to do that. Ano? And then finally, Judas. No? Judas who was very conflicted dahil sa kanyang pagiging alagad ni Kristo, pero at the same time, makasalanan din dahil nga sabi nga ng ebanghelyo, magnanakaw siya, dumudukot siya doon sa koleksyon, ano, or doon sa pondo ng grupo nila, no? And remember, lalo na pagdating natin sa Last Supper, to the very end, ang Panginoon mag-a-appeal kay Judas, no? Siguro maganda rin na alalahan din natin na merong bahagi ng pagkatao natin na makasalanan. Merong bahagi ng pagkatao natin na siyang kailangan ng biyaya ng Panginoong Hesukristo ngayong Holy Week na ito. Na yun yung bahagi ng ating mga pagkatao na dapat natin ialay sa Panginoon sa krus. Yung mga Judas sa ating pagkatao. Yung mga pagkakamali natin. At siguro sabi nga ng mga ibang manunulat, ang pinakamalaking kasalanan ni Judas ay hindi siya naniwala na mapapatawad siya ng Panginoon makikita natin sa mga darating na araw sa Ebanghelyo, si Pedro, si San Pedro, Peter will also betray Christ, will deny Christ. Pero sabi nga ng mga ibang manunulat, the difference is Peter believed in repentance and forgiveness, but Judas despaired. And perhaps during this Holy Week, let us bring ourselves to turn to God and to embrace the forgiveness that the grace of Holy Week really offers us in the cross and in the resurrection of Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Jesus' gentle reminder in manner invites us to turn humbly to Him for forgiveness. Assured of His compassion, let us bring our petitions before Him. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are suffering and experiencing difficulties in this time of the pandemic may bear their trials with patience, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may come to aid of the destitute, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may draw courage and strength from the cross of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone ahead of us in this life, in this time of crisis, may rest in God's peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pause for a moment and offer our personal prayers and intentions, praying especially for those who are suffering the most, the poor who have nothing to eat, the sick, and all those who lost loved ones during this time of the pandemic. Panalangin din natin lahat ng ating frontliners, lalong-lalo na yung mga doktor, ang mga nurse, ang mga staff ng mga iba't ibang ospital, lahat ng mga nagpapatupad ng quarantine, ng lockdown, at ganun din yung mga patuloy na nagtatrabaho para magkaroon ng konting normalcy ang ating mga buhay, ang mga nasa supermarket, drugstore, sa mga bangko, sa mga remittance centers, ang ating mga kasama sa media. Pinagdadasal ko lalo-lalo na ang team ng ABS, lalo na yung mga nag-aayos ng ating mga misa sa araw-araw. Pinapanalangin ko rin yung mga nag-aayos ng ating mga programa ngayong Holy Week. Panalangin natin na lahat ay maging ligtas sa sakit at maging mabuti ang kalusugan. Panalangin din natin lahat ng mga tumutulong, iba't ibang organisasyon, iba't ibang sangay ng gobyerno para maging normal at magkaroon ng konting normalcy sa buhay ng mga tao. At panalangin natin ang ating mga pamilya na sana ay tayo maging ligtas lahat sa virus na ito. Sandali tayong manahimik para ipanalangin ang ating mga kahilingan, lalong-lalo na ang pinangako natin na ialay sa ibang mga tao. At bigyan din natin ng pag-alaala ang mga namatay dahil sa virus at ang kanilang mga pamilya. Father, you sent your Son to us on a mission of mercy. Grant that he may always be comforted by his gentleness and strengthened by his presence in our lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness, we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look graciously, O Lord, upon the sacred mysteries we celebrate here, and may what you have mercifully provided to cancel the judgment we incurred bear for us fruit in eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Remember especially those who have died because of this pandemic. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now, with confidence, turn to God and offer to him the prayer that our Lord Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael, the Archangel, pray for us. Saint Roch, pray for us. Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. Saint Pedro Calungsod, pray for us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Santo Niño de Cebu, have mercy on us. Divine Mercy, have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Visit your people, O Lord, we pray, and with ever-watchful love, look upon the hearts dedicated to you by means of these sacred mysteries, so that under your protection we may keep safe this remedy of eternal salvation by which your mercy we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Lord, we come to you during this sacred time. As we renew our faith in your cross and resurrection, we pray that you will grant us the grace of healing and salvation. Amidst this crisis, grant us the strength of faith that comes from the power of your cross and resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.